Okay, good afternoon, good evening, whichever it happens to be. I'm Robert Newman. I'm a real estate marketing expert located out of Southern California. Hopefully, by this point, if you're watching this video, you've seen other videos, other blog posts of mine. If not, check them out. I think you'll enjoy them. All right, so tonight what we're doing is we're looking at Placester. Now, Placester is a real estate website technology provider. They provide what's called WordPress multi-sites. That's a real estate website that's built on WordPress. They're very simple to use, and they fall right in the middle in terms of price range. They range in price from it's $5 a month all the way up to $400 a month. On my blog post, which there will be some kind of connectivity to through this video, that those little buttons you push, you can take a look at this list, print it, do whatever you want with it, but it runs through all the pricing and the various details of their various offers. What I'm covering tonight, though, is I'm covering their platform. Now, I do want to say before we get too deeply into this review, in general, the only time that I feel like you should be looking at a company like Placester is if you are either in the first couple of years of your real estate career. The reason that I say that is that Placester is a rental site. Like, you rent these sites from Placester, whether you're spending $5 a month or you're spending $400 a month. Placester always owns both the website and the content that they put on the site. Now, they may tell you differently, but I promise you that the agreement that you sign says that they own the website. In addition, lately, Placester has really been ramping up its user base. And the reason that's important to you, a person that might be considering using them, is that in the real estate industry in general, with technology, it tends to be, like, these guys have been very well funded, Placester. It's founded by Matt Barba and Frederick Towns. And over the last number of years, they've gotten 15 different investors and venture capitalists to put in a total of $53 million. When that happens, what those people who are financing this company are looking for is they're looking to make money. The way they make money is by the company going public or getting a very large user base and then selling to an even larger technology company. Which is why Placester will never, most likely, I mean, there's no guarantees, but never most likely, offer up their websites to let you own them. So you're always going to be renting or leasing the site for them. The value that you're building up out of it is either leads that you're generating, so it comes down to what is your cost per lead and are you converting those into sales, versus other website offers. I don't believe that this website or its offerings are the best that you can find in either one of those categories. And I definitely don't believe in renting or leasing a website for a very similar amount of money. Let's say that you go with their medium offer, you're going to be spending about $4,000 or $5,000 a year. There is a lot that you can do for $4,000 or $5,000 a year. You can own your own WordPress website. You can hire a consultant to teach you how to use it correctly. You can get a much more hands-on approach than Placester will give you for the same money. Now, having said that, there are a lot of great things about Placester, and I don't want this to appear like I am giving them a savaging, because I'm not. They seem to be a good technology company, but I would only recommend them for real estate professionals who are in the first couple years of their career, or if you're with REMAX or you're with Keller Williams and you're forced into one of their sites. It's not a bad site to have, and you're probably getting it for free, and you can't beat that deal. Just keep in mind, this is somebody else's website. It's not yours. Seems like it's yours, has your branding on it, but they own it. And when they sell their company, and they will, then they're going to sell it to somebody who could trash the technology, could do a number of different things with it. So if you want to make big investments, like you have money and you want to be on the web, this is not the way to go. Start another website. However, having said that, let's get into how their website works. So we're looking at the dashboard, the actual backend of a Placester website. So it's site setting, pages. So we click on this, nothing happens. Click on pages. You can see it's very super easy to add a page. You click the plus button. You can see here it just gets you into a really easy to use WYSIWYG. It's asking you what kind of page it is. Do you want to put meta titles and meta descriptions into it? Placester themselves has an amazing blog with lots of great information. It's got to be my favorite thing about Placester is that they have taken so much time to build up the content on the site. They are great, like, for a beginning agent who wants to learn and learn about real estate specifically. Placester is the best place to start. I wish I had the time to put out the kind of library that they put out. I know. So it's great for that. But you can get all that information for free. You don't need to have one of their websites. Site setting, IDX integration. Most agents don't even understand that IDX means information data exchange. And it's basically a way of saying that Placester wants to take the information that your MLS provides, that you're already a member of, to be a realtor, and then they want to represent it in a different way to the world at large. So you have to have IDX integration. Featured listings, exactly what it sounds like. It's point and click. It's very easy to decide where your featured listings go. This particular site looks like this on the front end. It's clean. I like it. There's nothing wrong with it. When you click on a listing, this is the listing itself. Okay, you can email it to a friend. It's got pretty basic functionality. You can share it online. Now, Placester really does excel in one way, which is they have an amazing phone app. This app is for open houses. I strongly recommend that you check it out. It's got like 5,000 reviews, and most of them are 5 stars. So it's very, very super cool and connects into this. Maybe it doesn't connect into that, but I thought it would have connected into that. Anyway, you have lead capture. Now, this is a little tricky here. So I'm looking at the $5 version of the sites. Like I told you, there's many different versions of the site that you get. I have the login information to the cheapest version of these sites, or the least expensive. And it allows you to lead capture things, and the funny thing is it really actually doesn't allow you any of that, because these are the leads that this website has captured since last year, let's call it. But you have to upgrade to even see it. There's the whole lead generation section of the site. You don't even get access to it. I wasn't able to find anywhere in any documentation anything that said that Placester tells people that are signing up with Mark. I did see a number of reviews, though, that were really hammering Placester for basically, kind of like aggressive sales tactics or bait and switch. And I think that if they just simply said in a much clearer way, hey, $5 website, you can't get leads, it's just basically putting a shingle on the web, and that's it. Like, unless they call your phone number, nothing's going to happen. If they just said that, I think they would save themselves a lot of headache, but whatever. Okay, so this is what the primary dashboard does. You can go to edit the site. That's the place that we started at. It's all point and click. You probably would have to spend a couple of hours learning how to get good at this. You've got labels, tooltips, listing settings, home. It really is quite excellent and quite simple. Now, it's not very complex or adaptable. So, honestly, if there's anything advanced that you want to do, you will not be able to do it with this particular website. You will be able to post blogs, add agents, and most likely, if you advertise enough, you'll get some leads. Your lead conversion percentage will probably be much worse with Placester than other offerings of a similar type. IDX Broker, Real Geeks, they all have very high conversion rates. They're all much more complicated products. So if you don't have the time or you're a novice, this is probably a good place for you to start. Now, the site that we're looking at is $5 a month. If you're a member of NAR, that's the only way you can get into this one. Then their regular sites start at $150 a month. Their premium sites go up to $400 a month with a $250 activation. And if your broker is a member or a client, you can get a site for as little as $3.75 a month or for free, depending on how your broker works out that deal. So if you're extremely interested and you're working for a small broker and they're not providing any websites, this might be a good way for them to go, because for about $400 a month, maybe $450, they can get 10 agents on these sites, and they can then provide the website to you for free, which would be kind of cool. You get to choose your language. Putting in Google Analytics into these sites is very easy. Google Analytics will tell you where your traffic is coming from like this, and allow you to get into details about tracking the website. So it's a really good feature that they've got that so easily set up. They've also got what's called an XML sitemap that's easily populated and sends the information to Google. That's also a very cool marketing feature. It's a very minor one, but it's a very cool one. If you have any questions about Placester, please let me know. I don't believe that I will have an unlimited access to the site. So I'd love to hear any questions that you might have.